And so the men's double mini trampoline team final, the first event to take place in medals action at these World Championships. It is the Trampoline Gymnastics World Championships at the Ariake Gymnastics Center in Tokyo, Japan. The start list for the men's double mini trampoline team final. Great Britain as the lowest qualifiers will get things underway. We'll go all the way through to the Russian Federation with Andrei Gladenkov. And then we go back round once again. We finish with Mikhail Zalamin, and there's a fabulous gymnast to finish with. Thiago Sampaio Mal of Portugal. Third World Championships for him. Oh, that's some glorious work. The difference there between him and the previous competitor in terms of the amplitude was quite striking. Got lovely height. Good powerful run up. Nice contact, gets the toes pointed. The USA represented by Alex Renkert. And that was a lot to like. We'll get some 10th deductions for the paces back on the landing. Silver medal at the World Games in 2017, Alex Renkert. Will be that the judges see a little bit of imprecision in his toe pointing places. Now it's Oliver Paradise. 20-year-old from Bath in his World Championship debut. It's done nicely. Make sure to really hold it. Just gets a little bit of loss of form as he's coming to approach the second part of the pass. Youngest gymnast in this final, 17-year-old from Valladolid. Debut World Championships, looking good so far. Isn't he looking good so far? Wow. Well, fourth strongest in qualification for the men's individual final, and that's why. The tuck work here is lovely. So we have just one more gymnast, and then we're at the two-thirds mark of the competition. He's already won a team gold. Powerful. And very secure in terms of landing in the red. He'll take probably a tenth, not much more than that for the step back on his landing, but that will be really just the tonic for the Russian Federation. Super extension of the toes. Really keeps the heels clicked together wonderfully. So at the two-thirds mark, it's Russia, Great Britain, and the United States of America in medal contention. Diogo Carvalho Costa, the 24-year-old team all-around silver last year at the World Championships. A graduate of business administration from the Instituto Universitario de Maya. This is going to be huge if he can control it. Oh, what a delivery from Diogo Carvalho Costa. And then he turns away with the calmness of a man who does this all the time. Yes, he's going to take probably a 0.9 or thereabouts Here is Ruben Padilla. The United States are in third place, or were in third place coming into this rotation. This 18-year-old has been so very impressive thus far. Oh, wonderful! Just wonderful! Remember the name, Ruben Padilla. Lovely tuck position, very tight, and again, and he's got stability in that landing too. And so to Mikhail Zalomin of the Russian Federation. What a gymnast to finish with. Six times a world champion. He needs a 36.5 score to win it for Russia. Well, that's got to be enough, you would suspect, especially with the difficulty from Mikhail Zalomin. Super looking twist. Maybe just loses the arms a touch. Not there. Really tucked into the chest and crossed over. So it is gold for Russia for the third time in a row, the men's double mini trampoline team title. The final standings in the men's double mini trampoline team final, the bronze for Portugal, the silver for the USA, and the gold, as ever, for the Russian Federation. They've done it once more. Plenty of very, very happy looking gymnasts indeed. Many of them will be returning to participate in further competitions. The women's team tumbling final is about to get underway. I hope you're enjoying the action so far here in Tokyo. Great Britain, the strongest in qualification. Shanice Davidson, the best individual performer as well. Emily Wambot of France. Quite a lot of deviation, but she controlled that well at the end. Nice, powerful work. Perhaps not quite getting the angle in the pike position the judges might look for. Bravo. To Hope Bravo. Nice layout work. Can she keep this moving? Well, that was more secure than one of the passes that she had. Pretty good in the attack of the centre line. Just catches the mat, and that perhaps sends her spiralling off a little bit. Shanice Davidson. Top qualifier in this competition. Oh, she's a very high-octane tumbler. Isn't the centre line impressive? Not much to take away there from an execution standpoint. Wang Jingyi, the second gymnast to go for the People's Republic of China. Oh, yes. Oh, then just a little bit of a move back, interestingly. That was a slightly delayed 10th deduction. Yelena Krasnokutskaya in individual qualification. Powerful, powerful tumbling. This is looking big. And she has the control as well. Well, certainly the continuous power that's required in tumbling gymnastics was there for all to see. Stays on the central line. And what that means is that Great Britain produce an extension to their lead at the top of the table. Then it's Russia, then it's France. Marie Deloge of France, 22-year-old who aspires to work in the physiotherapy profession. Well, she really did go flying into the final skill, had a battle to stay on the mat, a battle that she wasn't fully able to win. Perhaps the form not the tidiest in terms of the layout work that she's ever produced. Difficult conclusion to the routine in terms of rotating round so that the gymnast lands square on the mat. That's very difficult to do with a final skill like that. Victoria Danilenko of the Russian Federation, the last gymnast to go, second best performer in the qualification. Second transition, can she get there? Of course she can. She looked a little unhappy with aspects of her form, perhaps, Danilenko. Extra work. And that makes it that bit harder for the gymnast to keep the momentum going. Certainly some opportunities for form deductions here and there, but she tucks in pretty nicely at the conclusion of the pass. They will be confident that that is going to get them something significant. What colour, though? And so to Megan Keely of Great Britain. Great Britain has led the whole way through this women's team tumbling final. Can they hold on at the end? The 19-year-old from Chertsey in Surrey. What an occasion handled by Megan Keely as she presents the judges. The look on her face says, I hope, I think, maybe I believe it's a job done. British gymnast making noise to rival the wonderful American team. Good central attack off the track. And then the layout work to finish was secure. Double layout kept the momentum going. And it's gold for Great Britain, Megan Keely. Final standings in the women's tumbling team competition. The bronze to France, the silver to the Russian Federation, and the gold to Great Britain. It is a first gold medal of these World Championships for Great Britain, a nation with a great history in the sport of trampoline gymnastics. So to the women's double mini trampoline team final. Women's double mini trampoline team final. It begins with Australia, the fifth strongest qualifiers. All eyes on the battle between Great Britain and the Russian Federation. Just 1/10 separating these two nations. Karina Haggerty of Australia, the first to go. Good, solid start from Australia. They like that in the sidelines, most definitely. Great Britain, the second strongest qualifiers. Here's Kim Beattie, the 21-year-old from Aberdeen. This is looking strong. And she's controlled the landing well as Kim Beattie. Second best overall in the individual qualification. Last year's British champion, this year's silver medalist. Good, elegant pike work. Young gymnast, the teenager, Galina Begim, 17-year-old. Big pass coming up. And that's an occasion handled. She kicks out of the pike work with a real sense of composure. Laurence Roux. Oh, that's another very nicely stuck landing. Oh, well. Gets the knees nicely tucked in. Kicks out well. The form perhaps in the second part of the pass, not quite as tidy. Kylie Lockett of Team USA. The 18-year-old from Oceanside in California. Didn't get perhaps as much height as some of the other gymnasts that we've seen. Just keeping the form difficult and just lost a little bit of her power perhaps on the flatbed. Just got time to bring you the standings, and what a story this is developing into. Now to the USA and Tristan Van Natter. Great gymnastics family. Here she goes. All that's going to be very helpful indeed to USA. Control the twist well. She's got very good lower body strength. So USA have guaranteed themselves a medal. It's now to Kirsty Way of Great Britain, the final competitor. Held it well at the end. How was the form at the start of the pass? It's a very nervy and exciting women's team double mini trampoline final. Some deductions at that early point of the pass for Kirsty Way, but not an awful lot to remove in the second stage. Last gymnast, it's the Russian Federation competing. It's going to be very interesting. Polina Troyanova. Russian Federation attempting to hold on to their title from 2 years ago. Gold for the United States of America. The final standings in the women's double mini trampoline team final. The bronze to the Russian Federation, the silver to Great Britain, and the gold to the United States of America. The bronze, silver and gold awarded here in the women's double mini trampoline team competition. So to the men's team tumbling final. The start list for the men's team tumbling final, and it is going to be Great Britain who enter this as the top qualifiers with quite a margin over the USA. Alexander Lizitsin of the Russian Federation, 21-year-old from Krasnodar. Beautiful height, can he keep this going? Oh, he certainly can, to real effect. Let's enjoy it again, and enjoy is the right word, because this was high octane. Still, the details are there. Good toe point in the twist early on. Tries to get the knees really right up to get that extra rotation in the tuck to add to the difficulty score. Good central line as well. Trying to get that triple secured. Alex Renkert, the 26-year-old from Indianapolis, in his eighth World Championships, has won tumbling and double mini trampoline medals. Gymnast who retired 4 years ago, and he began working as the marketing director for a company called Integrity Athletics. They had such a great trampoline tumbling program, and he had to walk past it every single day to get to his office. And he just thought, enough is enough, I'm going to have a little go at this once more. Meng Wenqiao of the People's Republic of China. Currently in fifth position where they qualified, People's Republic of China. Fourth World Championships for Meng Wenqiao. Does do a lot with the twists. Packs the skills in. Gets good height, good line, lovely toe point in the second transition work. Have another look at this final stage. Really good toe extension, actually. Blake Granger from Australia. First world championship for him. Three times competes at the Junior Worlds, including a silver medal last year. A little bit low, but he's picked up some height now. Did nicely, Blake Granger, because it looked a little bit at the start of the pass as though he was losing some height. Tidy first transition. It was there that he needed to get things moving once more. The second half, if you will, had a little bit more amplitude on the backflips. Great Britain in a good position. Here's Elliot Brown. Oh, indeed. Well, Elliot Brown has got this wonderful feature to his tumbling where right towards the end of the pass, he seems suddenly to find a sixth gear. I wonder what's going through his mind as he relives this. Good form in the transition work, and then he really picks up the pace. Yes, a little asymmetry. It is Great Britain, two marks plus ahead of the Russian Federation, who've got a good margin over Australia. Vadim Afanasyev of the Russian Federation, the reigning world tumbling champion. And he is a treat to watch. Just 19. He's been a touch on the uneven side this year, has Afanasyev. Either wins it or doesn't make the final, but this was very strong. Third world championship for Afanasyev. First transition, the twist keeps the heels beautifully pressed together, picks up the speed, twisting into the pike position with just a fraction of asymmetry and a small step back. Caden Brown of the United States of America, the 18-year-old from Utah. He attends the University of Utah studying exercise science. He's also a black belt in taekwondo and a very good baseball player. And he's a rather good tumbler too, isn't he, Caden Brown? Second world championships for the teenager. He's been close to the medals on a number of occasions. This is a great display from Caden Brown. He's got great toe point. Gets the arms pretty nicely into the side. He does lose the central line a fair bit as the second half of the pass builds. Hugely animated reaction from Fitzgerald. Jaden Paddock, the last gymnast to go. Well, this is going to be absolutely fascinating. Jaden Paddock of Great Britain, the 18-year-old from Walsall, reigning junior world and European champion, in his world championship debut, has delivered a very big pass for Great Britain. Great first transition, bang on the centre line, little deviation towards the end, gets it back, super symmetry and big rotations in the pike. Yes indeed, they're saying, they have belief. Nod of the head from Christoph Willerton, a hug from the coach. Jaden Paddock with a score of 38 gives Great Britain the World Championship title in men's team tumbling. So the final standings in the men's team tumbling final. The USA taking the bronze medal, the Russian Federation the silver, and it's a gold medal for Great Britain. Great Britain had quite a margin to play with in this competition and they added to it. It was a brilliant performance in the final after a very impressive qualification.